In this short tutorial, I'm going to show you how to downgrade a Premiere Pro project. So say if you're working on 2023 and you want to open a 2024 Premiere Pro project file, how do you do that? I'm going to show you a free online tool that you can use to downgrade Premiere Pro projects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So just to show you here, I'm inside Premiere Pro 2023. I'm going to go open up a project created in Premiere Pro 2024. As you can see, when I select it and click open, you'll notice that this dialog box opens and it says it can't open in this version. So what we're going to do is use this free online tool. I've linked it down in the video description. If you want to go and click on it, feel free to open it up and follow along to downgrade your project. So once you have it open, you're going to click on Browse for File and navigate to your Premiere Pro project. Once you have it, click on it and click Open, and then it will convert it. So next you can click Download File. Now, one important note is that this free online tool converts it to Premiere Pro version 2018. So you should be good within the last few years of using Premiere Pro. So if you have Premiere Pro 2020 or 2021, you can now open old files using this converter. So you can see it downloaded. I recommend changing the name of it. So I'm going to change the name to Downgraded. That way I know this is a downgraded project. Then I'm just going to move this into my project files folder. Once it's in there, I'm going to go back into Premiere Pro and go to Open Project. Once I have it selected, I'm going to click on it and click Open. And as you can see, it's going to ask me to convert the project from the 2018 file to the 2023 version. So I'm just going to confirm the file location and then click OK. There you have it. We've downgraded our project and opened it inside Premiere Pro 2023. So just one final note I do want to say, if you open a new project created from like 2024 or in the future and you open it on an older version, a lot of effects and things that are included in the 2024 version aren't available in older versions of Premiere Pro. So just know that if you use an effect or a tool, that those type of clips might be a little corrupt or you might have some missing files here and there. But otherwise, this should work for you. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments section below. But otherwise, I hope this video was helpful if you wanted to see how to do that.